obvious question is,
Yeah, feeling real good. I've been doing everything I can, you know, in my power to be available for this team. You know, and my role has, you know, progressed. And, you know, I'll leave my status and my role up to the coaches and training staff. But, you know, I'm doing my part to make sure I'm rehabbing as hard as I can, practicing as hard as I can, and just being ready when my number's called.
Have you been surprised how fast you were able to get back into some kind of shape after
the Achilles? As soon as that injury happened, I set my mind to a certain goal, and you know, it wasn't like a timeline goal, but like, hey, every single day I have an opportunity to recover from this and work my butt off, and that's how I approached it. And you know, I'm pretty happy with where I'm at, considering, you know, 30 years old going into year 9. You know, I'm excited for when my number does get called.
Eric, again, it's not your call, the final decision. What do you need to see this week to tell yourself that you're ready?
I think, you know, a big part of playing O-line is, you know, confidence. And I think, you know, I took strides in that last week with the reps that I got. And, you know, I'm feeling pretty darn good. So I think, you know, just go out there, give it my all today, and, you know, come out of this week feeling good. And I'll leave it up to, you know, the people who make those decisions to what my status is on Sunday.
Eric, not to get ahead of yourself, but do you think you could be the player you once were? You feel like you'll be back at that level again?
Yeah, definitely. I have a pretty level mind. I take things on bluntly and reasonably. And, you know, I don't think there's any doubt in my mind the way I feel, you know, especially with, you know, how things work around here. You know, the training staff is just awesome. And, I definitely think I can return to the level of play, if not take the next step in my career.
You mentioned as soon as the play happened, you made the decision to get back. What do you remember from that play? You guys were up big, and I watched the tape, and it didn't look like there was anything obvious, but what comes to mind when you think of that snap?
Yeah, something I've done thousands of times. You know, it was that was just God's plan for me, and you know, it brought me here. You know, I don't think when it happened, you know, I'd be somewhere else in the country come fall. But you know, things happen, and adversity happens, and I think it's just a matter of how you respond to it. And you know, it was quite a wild ride, but you know, and I've been in one system with one coaching staff with one playbook, you know, for my entire career. And you know, sometimes things just get changed up in life. You got to shake it up a little bit and handle adversity as it comes, man. Control what you can control. You know, I can't help that, you know, my Achilles ruptured. It is what it is. And but you know, I'm excited for the opportunity here in Indy, and gonna make the most of it.
What did you a couple more? What was it like watching? I think you watched the Super Bowl with the Patriots. Come with that.
Yeah.
Especially with how the game went.
Yeah, I actually sat in a plywood box. I think it was a few extra stands there in Tampa. That was tough, man. You know, I take pride in my availability for my team. And, you know, being there 8 years, you know, it was something we built. And to watch the Super Bowl, you know, especially playing in the fourth quarter up 2 scores the game prior. I mean, the Super Bowl's, you know, the thing we work for every single day. So it sucked. Put it straightforward, it sucked. But, you know, that's life.
Eric, I know that timelines are always like a moving target, but when you think back to conversations with training staff and doctors when this first happened, I mean, do you feel like this is earlier than you thought you might be here, or do you have any sense of that?
No. You know, I kind of, you know, relied on doctors, trainers, the trainers I worked with, you know, did a lot of research for me, and, you know, there's a lot of different timelines out there, and I knew that linemen have come back 6, 7, 8 months, and so I knew it wasn't out of the question. And like I said, I just controlled my attitude every day, and here I am.
Hey, your mentality in Kansas City, do you see carryovers here? You knew where the Chiefs were. How close is this team? I guess is how many fans are. You have such a unique view of that. What carries over?
What carries over is, you know, just, I mean, we're an AFC team. that was a playoff contender last year. We have a lot of talent on this team, and you know, putting that talent to work and getting that cohesiveness, and I think we can do something special here. You know, obviously it didn't start the way we wanted to last week, but I think everyone's got a good mindset, and we have high goals for ourselves, and we're looking forward to facing the challenges that come this year.
Hey, Eric, last one here.
At what point in your recovery did you stop thinking about the Achilles? You know, instead of thinking, okay, it's something that happened, was there a point where you said, okay, I'm just in the process of getting back on the football field, not looking down at it, not thinking about wondering how it's going to respond?
Yeah, probably sometime in like July when I started, you know, doing some O-line reps, you know, just on air, moving around, changing direction. You know, eventually, you know, confidence builds, man. And then, you know, I think that's a hard part of coming off a major injury is not thinking about your injury. But, you know, I trust the training staff and the coaches here to put me in good positions. And, you know, so it's actually really nice moving around out here. It's not a thought.